Ontario Science Centre. I'm here with my daughter,
Sophia,
and my son,
Nathan.
Today, we're going to be exploring bubble membranes, a twist on making bubbles. You're going to need some sugar, dish soap, water, cotton string, measuring spoon, a teaspoon, scissors, straws, a pencil, thread, and a shallow bowl. Sophia and Nathan are going to start by making the bubble solution. We're going to make it in this measuring cup and start with 140 mils of water. Ten mils of soap, and 2 teaspoons of sugar. If you have a recipe that has glycerin in it, that would be okay too. I didn't have glycerin at home, so I'm using sugar. Give it a good stir. Thanks, Nathan. And now they're gonna make the bubble contraction. To make the bubble contraption, you cut a straw in half and you cut a piece of string about the length of your arm. There you go.
There we go.
Yeah. About the length of your arm. Good. Thread the string through the 2 pieces of straw. And then tie the string. And then cut the hanging edges or the hanging threads off. There we go. And tuck the knot into the straw. Perfect. Hold it up so you get a rectangle like that. So depending on the size of your bowl, you'll make it a different size. Okay, so today we're going to do a couple things. You have 5 tasks to do today. First, to create a bubble membrane. Second, to put an object through the bubble membrane. Third, to create a pore in the bubble membrane or a hole in the bubble membrane. And to create the pore or hole, you'll need a piece of thread that's already looped. It's easier if you do it beforehand because your hands are going to be very soapy, so it's hard to create this loop. Okay. Put the loop, create a pore on the bubble membrane, and then remove that pore so the membrane reforms. And the last thing you're going to do is use a straw that hasn't been in the soapy solution to make a bubble within the bubble. Sophia and Nathan are going to get you started by creating a bubble membrane and then trying to put something through it.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Okay, we've got a nice bubble membrane. Nathan's going to try and put
I'm moving my finger.
Okay, Nathan's going to try and put the pencil through it. Oh, popped.
Dang it. Oh, Nathan.
All right. Any other thoughts on how you might get the pencil through it?
The tip poked it, so I'm just gonna get the tip. Yay!
Nice.
Oh.
All right, so see if you can get the entire pencil all the way through. Nathan, can you show us your finger? Maybe leave the pencil for a second and show us how you do that with your finger.
Okay.
So Nathan can also do it with his finger.
Nice.
So, what's going on here? Soap is an amphipathic molecule, which means it has a hydrophilic head, or water-loving head, that's attracted to water, and a hydrophobic tail, which is attracted to fats. If we take a cross-section of the membrane and we look at how the molecules are arranged in the bubble membrane, we can see that they line themselves up in two rows, trapping water in the middle. The hydrophilic heads are pointing towards the water in the middle, and the hydrophobic tails are pointing towards the air on the outside. If we want to pass an object through the membrane, only objects that are chemically similar to the bubble membrane can pass through. So when the pencil is dry and doesn't have soap on it, it pops the membrane and cannot go through. However, you saw that Sophia and Nathan added soap to the pencil, coated the pencil in soap. Now, the outside of the pencil looks like a bubble, has the same chemical properties of a bubble. And so when they put the pencil through the membrane, it went straight through the membrane without popping it. Understanding this concept then allows you to do things like create a pore, like you did with the thread, removing that pore, and also creating a bubble within a bubble. So how's a bubble membrane like the cell membrane? You and I and all living things are made up of cells. And cells are surrounded by a membrane that controls what enters and leaves the cell. Membranes are made of molecules called phospholipids. Phospholipid has a hydrophilic head and two hydrophobic tails. Sound familiar? They are very similar to our soap molecule, which is amphipathic. Phospholipids are also amphipathic. If we look at the cell close up, inside the cell, the phospholipids line themselves up so that their hydrophilic heads point towards the inside of the cell and the outside of the cell, which are composed mostly of water, and their hydrophobic tails point towards the middle. They form this double layer. We call this a phospholipid bilayer. This creates a barrier between the inside and the outside of the cell and controls what enters and leaves the cell. Because this molecule is very similar to the soap molecule, soap bubbles actually are very similar to our membrane. They have the same consistency and they behave in a similar way to our cell membranes. Just like in the bubble membrane, only substances that are chemically similar to our cell membrane will pass through the cell membrane. So here we've got oxygen. It's small and it's nonpolar, which means it's not hydrophilic. Oxygen passes easily through the cell membrane into the cell, or alternatively, it can pass from the inside to the outside. However, big molecules like glucose, which is also hydrophilic, can't pass through the membrane. They actually get stuck in the middle layer of the membrane where the hydrophobic tails are. Instead, they have to pass through a pore or a channel. So our cell membranes have pores or channels made out of proteins. So just like you created a pore with the thread, here we've got a pore or a channel through which the glucose molecule can pass. In terms of a bubble within a bubble, the cell is exactly that. So the cell membrane is one bubble, and inside the cell membrane, you've got a whole bunch of little bubbles, the organelles. Each organelle is surrounded by its own membrane. So the mitochondria has a membrane, the chloroplast in plants have membranes, the nucleus has a membrane. So your cell is a bubble within a bigger bubble. Bubbles, fun and educational. For more information on this concept, please consult our companion documents.